stage two of the UAE Tour and a modest encounter, I think it's fair to say, with the time trial bikes. No fear from the organisers about insisting that teams bring over these highly specialised machines, and they were put to the test on an extraordinarily short test of just 12.1 kilometres in length. Sinuous, however, and with a stiff, although consistent, north-northwesterly wind, it meant that it was a headwind largely until the turn at the far northern part of, indeed, our course. Well, with such a short route, this could well play into the hands of the power men, the classics men as well, and not necessarily favour those who have time-trialing ability in abundance, of which we had a few. Time to get underway for Brennan McNulty. Not the overall standings used as our start list, but pre-selected, and indeed his team thought about the wind. Stiffening towards the afternoon, it was set, and McNulty went off early. Captain America bringing it home in spectacular fashion. Well, there had been some pretty good, we thought, times earlier on, but this was to be something of a benchmark. 53.977 kilometres per hour, and McNulty's time at the line, stopping the clock at 13 minutes and 27. Peo Bilbao marked the best placed of those running overall to have a go at this sort of thing. Used to be very good time trialist, and so it proved again. In fact, of the men who will be battling out for the title, Bilbao really has now announced himself. Don't take anything away from Brennan McNulty, however. He could well be supported throughout this race. Let's wait and see. Adam Yates set off to try and beat his teammate and indeed perhaps establish a pecking order within UAE Team Emirates. Fifth quickest at that point. He was to drop outside of the top 10 by the end, Adam Yates. But UAE had not finished at all. Their times were coming thick and fast. Mikel Biao also doing a spectacular run there. At that point, that was 1 and 2 for the UAE Team Emirates, but you can't without Jay Vine, who himself, an excellent time trialist, has blown hot and cold of late, but to be fair, he was absolutely on it today. Well, if UAE Team Emirates wanted to impress the home crowd, they certainly did that. And this was wrap-up time, giving themselves an amazing gift. McNulty sitting at the top of a pile of teammates on the podium. Well, there are some youngsters here as well, we remind you. And quite frankly, they are shining brightly. Tobias Foss, former world champion, he just could not manage it on the way home. Good enough for fourth place, but nothing could upset and upset the men at the top of the standings. Well, we had to finish proceedings, and of course it was Tim Bollea, winner of Stage 1. He'll have his sprinting days on Stages 4, 5 and 6, but it's the high ground tomorrow, so the time he seeded today, a minute and 26 by the time he closed out proceedings, it meant that Brennan McNulty was our new race leader. Fine performance by McNulty, as well as the rest of the UAE team. Jay Vine, Biao rounding out the podium ahead of Tobias Foss, Kepplinger and Van Wilder. But it was Captain America who flew home today, brilliantly so. Great work. Now he's just got to repeat it when it comes to the high ground, and they've got some decisions to make when it comes to breakfast tomorrow, Team UAE. This is how it stacks up overall. McNulty in charge, ahead of Jay Vine, just 2 seconds. Teammate Biao as well. And just outside of the top 10 there is Adam Yates. They have to take care. They have to perhaps take this man all the way. Let's wait and see. Brilliant work today by that team. And what of tomorrow? Destination Jebel Jais. Longer stage, 176 kilometres in total. Does loop a bit, but it's the finish that counts for so much. When you see the altimetry, it starts to look a bit scary. It's an ice hockey stick of a stage with a very, very tough climb at the end. Something that Adam Yates can master, but will he be allowed to do so with his team functioning so brilliantly in so many quarters? We shall have to wait and see. So the land, the road, tips up to the sky tomorrow. We'll see you then.